Hello, my fine feathered friends. This is Songbird, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your server through Nitrado. If you're just logging in for the first time, you can just go to www.nitrado.com or .net. It doesn't really matter. It'll forward you to the correct place, and there you go. It's already automatically logged me in because I've been on here before. You will need to set up an account. You can just click on the game, or you can click up here under game server, either way, and just choose the package that you want to sign up. If you just want to download something or just try out a server, you can get one for just as little as 3 days, but of course most people are going to want it for longer than that. And so you can do the 20 slot for 30 days or for 90 days and save a little bit of money. You can also save 10% by using my code that is in the description. And then if you enter the code SONGBIRD10 at checkout, you will get 10% off of the regular price. So make sure to do that. Then once you've got that set up, once you've checked that out, I'm not going to show that whole process, then you'll be able to go up to your name, your account here, and scroll down to My Services. And if you click on My Services, it'll bring up your servers. So right now I have 3 servers through Nitrado, and this is the one that I need to set up today. So I'm going to click on the web interface. There we go. And the server is stopped. I didn't want random people hopping on it before I'm ready to even set it up. It's got all your basic data here. But what you're going to want to do is go over to the settings and click general. All of this stuff, you don't have to actually go through and change it. You can if you want to. But there is an easier way, because also this does not include by default all of the possible options you may want to change in INI. So the easier way to do this actually is to go here to config files. Just click on that. And then I've got a couple of different files that I use here. Let me make this a little bit smaller so I can show you what I'm doing. The Nitrado UI seems pretty complicated at first, and it may not be the easiest to use, but it's not too bad once you learn your way around it. And this is definitely the easiest way I've found of setting up servers. All right, so I've got a notepad document here that I've saved from other servers I have set up with ASA. And these are based off of server configs that I used for Ark Survival Evolved. A lot of them are the same. So first we've got the game.ini that I change. What we've got here, just the basic gist of all of this, is I've got settings to lightly boost harvesting and breeding and mating cooldowns, baby raising, all of those kinds of things. I've got all of my basic settings for that. I usually like to turn down the resource, no replenishing radius. I don't like it if there's a big dead zone around everything that I build, you know, where things don't respawn. So I turn that down so that plants and rocks will respawn a little closer to my structures. So there's a bunch of different settings like that in there. And then this here, all of this, that I am indebted to my friend Anandamira for putting this together. But this is a bunch of the different items in the game that by default don't stack or don't stack very high. And she put together the coding to make those things stack. So we've got prime meat will stack up to 25. Also honey will stack up to 25. Thatch and hide will stack up to 500. Organic polymer stacks up to 100. Lightweight things, we usually have them stacking up to 500 just to save space in inventory and in containers. So this is not a stacking mod. I don't usually use stacking mods, but you can change your stack sizes just using your server INI. So that's what this is. So you can look through if you want, and you can tinker with the sizes of stacks or delete things if you don't want to change them from the defaults. But basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy this entire note here, and I'm going to paste this over in here. There we go. So now it's all in here, and I'm going to click save. And these documents, these notes are available on Discord. I'm happy to share my configs with you, and then you can just copy paste them and drop them into your own server and save a ton of time. You can also work on setting up your own using a notepad document. That's basically what I did, so that then any server that you set up, you can just copy paste those over. So right now, all of the game user settings, I are just on the default. So I switched over to the game user settings, and I've got a separate note with all of these configs. And this is a lot of different little things in here, like your always allow structure pickup is in here, the number of structures allowed on rafts or platform saddles is in here, show floating damage text, the structures in range has been raised, the max tame dinos has been raised. There are a lot of different settings in here. You can go through it if you would like, but the easiest thing to do is I'm just going to copy it, Control C, Control A first, and then Control C. And then over here, I'm going to do a Control A and a Control V to replace them with mine. And then I've got stars next to things that you will still need to go through and change. So I can just do Control F to open up the find, and then I can put a star in there, and it will show me all of the things that are starred. So this is where you're going to set your admin password for your server that will allow you to enable cheats if you need to. For example, if a player gets stuck, somebody's dino gets meshed or something like that, and you want to be able to get into admin mode to be able to help them out, you would enter enable cheats and then this password. So you want to set up a password there and write it down somewhere, make a note on your desktop or something so that you don't forget what that password is. And then the next one that I have set, this is your server password. If you don't set up a password, then any random person who finds your server in the list of unofficial servers will be able to hop on. If you want to be able to keep your server just for your friends and people that you know, then you'll want to set up a password and give that password to your friends. And then here's your server name. This is what your friends are going to search for when they're looking for your server. So make sure to set that to something unique that you will remember. And then the last one is the message of the day. The message of the day is what pops up when players first join the servers. I usually like to just put some goofy little joke or quote or something like that in there. Not really any reason to leave it at the default. You can just say welcome if you want to. Let's see, what are we gonna, we need some kind of goofy dad joke. So let's just go ahead and change that. And you'll want to get rid of the stars. The stars are just to make it easier to find these. But yes, when you're changing these things, setting up your passwords and your messages and so forth, make sure to delete the stars. So what do you get when a dino sneezes? Out of the way. Okay, here we go. I can also go back up the list here, server name. I'm gonna call this server Beach Bob's Ascended, because why not? All right, and then we would just click save changes. There we go. And that's all set up now. And if you want to add any mods to your server, you can do that over here via the CurseForge mods tab. And I was gonna try to set it for Svartalheim, but that's still not available for servers.
Editing Songbird here to say that it wasn't available when I recorded this, but it is available now. In fact, I have a crossplay Svartalheim server for my member community, which you can join, by the way, for as little as $3 a month.
This is a favorite mod of mine just for making signs that are easier to read and have a lot more options. Lets you change the fonts, things like that. So you can choose to use mods or not use mods. You can choose to use quality of life mods to make things a little easier or less grindy for yourself, or you can choose to add mods that will make the game even harder than it already is. You can add additional creatures to tame or to add additional hazards to the world. It is all up to you. Another favorite one that I will often add is this custom dino levels mod, which all you have to do is click that one and it'll add it to the list up here. That's all you need to do. Neither of these require any INI edits, anything like that. You just pretty much plug and play. And this one would make it a lot easier to find higher level dinos because it just equalizes the chances of creatures spawning at any level. So you have an equal chance of finding a level 5 or a level 150 or any other number in between. You may notice, though, that there's not a super easy way to just scroll through. You can just go through the pages of the mods and just click on the ones you want to add, or you can search. So if you wanted to search for, say, a cryopod mod, for example, then you could just search and you could see there's several if you want to find out information about them. There isn't really a way that I've figured out in here to click from Nitrado's website over to CurseForge. What you're going to want to do is to just go to, I just search CurseForge Arc Mods and you'll find it right there. And then in here you can search, and if you actually look at the mod, it will give you some information about it. And if there's any things that you can configure or change about it through INI edits, then it will also include those in the information. And then if you decide that you want that mod, you can just search the name over on Nitrado's website. This is a new one. Oh, this one lets you landscape your base, essentially. That's pretty cool. I may have to take a closer look at that one. And you'll see that a lot of them also will have comments. You can see how many people have downloaded this mod, which that can be helpful because, you know, if thousands and thousands of people have already downloaded a mod, then you can guess that it's probably pretty stable, not gonna have any major bugs. If you have any questions, the comment section can be a good place to ask those. Sometimes the modder may also have a Discord. If you click on their name, it looks like this guy does not. But sometimes under the description, it'll have a Discord listed. And that can also be a good place to find out more information about the mod. And you can check out the comments, etc. And then just back over here on Nitrado, you could just search for it. So anyway, that's how you do that. And then you would just click Save Changes. And then you'll want to click back over to your general settings page here and just check that everything is set up properly. So I'm recording this before the game has launched on consoles. So as of right now, PC only is the only option. But later on, you will have the option of setting up a server that is for crossplay or that is only for Xbox or only for PlayStation 5. It will be up to you. And okay, we've got our server name, password, admin password, message of the day. Looks good. Message of the day duration, the default is 30 seconds, but that just seems too long to me, so I changed it to 15. The map name, right now the only option is the island. Later on we may have more options. You can change the autosave interval if you would like to. It can tend to produce a lag spike whenever it is saving the game, so you kind of have to balance the rubber banding and lag spike you may get when it saves with the fact that if the map crashes or something and rolls back, the save interval is usually the longest that it may roll back. So if you don't want to risk it rolling back 15 minutes, you can set it for 10 minutes, or you can set it for 5 minutes. Or I've been on some servers where the autosave interval was 30 minutes. So that is up to you to decide. I haven't really had problems with duping, so I did not enable additional dupe protection. I don't need a battle eye because it's only going to be me and a few friends playing on here. Don't need additional software potentially causing problems. and start with backup. You want to start with the current save game. Just leave it on this. That will start it with, you know, wherever you left off.
And then you just click save and then click start server.
It should be up in about 10 minutes, sometimes less. ASA seems to load faster than ASE did. So then you can just search for your server by name in the unofficial server list. Make sure to check the box for show password protected servers if you have set a password. Otherwise, it won't come up in the list. So make sure you do that. And other than that, have fun. So anyway, I hope that was helpful. If you have any further questions, please leave them in the comments section down below. And if you have watched this all the way to the end, I really appreciate that. Thanks so much. Why don't you leave a sunshine emoji down in the comments? If you have any further questions about mods or about servers or how to set it up, don't hesitate to ask. Either here, I do check all the comments, or you can message me on Twitter or on my Discord as well. I'll see you around. Have a great day. Bye-bye, my friends.